Hello everyone and welcome to this fourth character quick breakdown of Soul Calibur 6. Today I'm going to talk about one of the most creative characters ever, Maxie. I tested the character during my invitation to Bandai Namco. In this video, I will be helped by someone I have known for 17 years now, also my team captain, who has won several titles in the Soul Calibur competitive scene, Saito. He has played Maxie a lot in Soul Calibur 5 and analyzed the character in Soul Calibur 6 videos.
Hello everyone!
Just as all videos in this series, we will first see the changes we have noticed. In the second part, we will talk about the new attacks but also his new mechanics which concern his stance shifting. Finally, we will try to define his game plan, his strengths and weaknesses. You will have a reminder on the top right corner of your screen. It's the Soul Calibur notation. Feel free to pause if needed. But now, let's get into the Dragon's Lair. For you, Saito, who played Maxie a lot, how would you usually define him?
Maxie, the violent nunchuck of the East, is one of the most entertaining characters to play in any fighting games, thanks to the endless and creative potential of his stances transitions. It's a very offensive character, which can rely on his stance in transition. It causes problems for both beginners, who will struggle to get rid of his unstoppable sequences that will cause counterattacks, and experienced players, even if they are more patient and cautious.
By analyzing all the attacks we have seen so far in the Soul Calibur 6, we can notice that as for the other characters, Maxie gets a better command list than in previous Soul Calibur, the mix of all Soul Calibur games. However, our biggest regret will be the absence of Pure Soul Loop 3, which allowed Maxie to transition from right outer to left outer stances. Apart from that, there are some missing moves such as the low attack follow-up after the right outer key, as well as other low attacks which are missing in some stances. But a lot of good attacks are back to compensate and Saito will make you a list.
Indeed, many attacks were missing in Soul Calibur 5, making Maxie more basic and much less fun to play. Fortunately, a lot of them are back this time. First, the Wavering Light stance, introduced in Soul Calibur 4, which allows Maxie to access an auto-GI against verticals from any of his other 5 stances. Moreover, he has an additional option, since he can do his critical edge now. Then, we saw the return of several attacks to reinforce his approach game plan, like the 4-4 AB from Soul Calibur 2, fast-tracking move that let him go to his right outer stance, 2-3-6B, which represents a good option to close the gap while jumping, and especially the 3-3-BA from Soul Calibur 4, which is the best option to attack from mid-range and set up his stance game. Finally, we can also mention his low poke. The former 3B+K, the common is now 1B. More surprisingly, his whole Soul Calibur 2-6A+B come back, and should be while standing A+B now.
But we also seen some interesting new things, let's check that in the next part. Like other characters, Maxie has been rewarded with some new attacks. His universal break attack A+B allows him to make a direct punch with positive frame advantage on block and let him in the right outer stance. We also noticed two other promising attacks. His new AA in the right cross stance are two middle attacks that prevent sidestepping, plus a break attack in the second one. But it also allows counter-attack combo with an EV punch. The other attack is his new 6-6 A+B, which helps to approach while preventing sidestepping and end in stance. In addition to the return of the Wavering Light that we mentioned in the previous part, the developers have offered him two new mechanics to improve his stance game, and we will see that right away with Saito.
One of Maxie's biggest challenges in the previous games was that, at a competitive level, you often have to play without his special loop transitions because it was risky and easily punishable. So players were often forced to play a solid game with few stances. To help with that, two new mechanics appear in this Soul Calibur. Firstly, Maxi gets an auto GI against horizontal attacks when he executes a pure soul loop, completed with his wayrowing light stance, which auto GI vertical attacks. He is now better armed to protect his transition game. Secondly, when Maxi succeeds in a pure soul loop, the next attack has improved properties, which gives a better reward for the risk taken by using this fence. For example, after a pure soul loop transitions to B and lower, B option will acquire the lethal hit property and open on a combo.
So how do you play him? Maxi can still be played with his very solid poke game, mainly with his BA, A and 4B. At midrange, you will have to close the gap with his tools like 3-3 BA or 6-6 A plus B. At close range, Maxi has to condition the opponent to make him respect his strengths. Then he can deploy his stance shifting game. This will allow you to harass your opponent while damaging his guard bar and eventually cause mistakes that will lead in counter it or lethal it thanks to his new pure soul loop mechanics. In soul charge, Maxi has also boosted attacks that will initiate his stance game. For example, the 6A plus B, which is already a very good attack, will have a better range in soul charge and allow to transition to his left inner stance. He will still have the advantage for a mix-up. The soul charge also allows Maxi to increase his damage conversion from stance. We have seen in the reveal trailer that Soul Charge unlocks a follow-up punch after his right outer A. But also in Behind Lower, Soul Charge will unlock a follow-up to his low kick with Dragon Kick. To conclude, Saito, what are the strengths and weaknesses of this Maxi?
Maxi keeps a good range and safe moves to close the gap with good pokes. He still has significant damages combo in counter hits. Finally, thanks to his new mechanics, his pure soul loop seems even more unpredictable. On the side of the weaknesses, he has an average punishment game, but his soul charge 6 A plus B can help him. He remains a character with very few tools to zone or create space. It makes him very dependent on his offense. Even if it's safer than before, each feint and stance shifting keeps some risks. It will also be necessary to see if there are no universal answers to it, and if the critical edge will not be too efficient against his stances.
In conclusion, Maxi is a character made for you if you like to harass the opponent in close range with your creativity. I hope you enjoyed discovering the changes and new mechanics for Maxi. The character seems to be very rewarding for creative players, it really makes me want to play it. And for you, Saito?
The battle director of the game is a big Maxi player. That explains how he found the mechanics to overcome his weaknesses, while encouraging players to use more his stance shifting mechanic, Maxi's particularity.
If you liked my quick breakdown and would like to see others, please leave me a blue thumb. Share with your friends who might be interested in this character and subscribe to my channel to support me. Also, do not hesitate to use the comment section to tell me how I can improve the content for you and suggest me the characters you would like to see next. I also have other type of video for Soul Calibur 6, but it will come next days. Take care of you, my friends, and see you next time.
Later, everyone.